You look so wonderful in your dress. I love your hair like that. The way it falls on the side of your neck, down your shoulders and back. We are surrounded by all of these lies, and people talk too much. You got the kind of look in your eyes, as if no one knows anything but us. Should this be the last thing I see? I want you to know it's enough for me. Cause all that you are is all that I'll ever need. So in love. So in love. So in love. So in love. You look so beautiful in this light, your silhouette over me. The way it brings out the blue in your eyes is the Tenerife Sea. And all of the voices surrounding us here, they just fade out when you take a breath. Just say the word and now we'll disappear into the wilderness. Should this be the last thing I see? I want you to know it's enough for me. Cause all that you are is all that I'll ever need. So in love. So in love. So in love. So in love.
to fall, but watching you stand alone, all of my doubt suddenly goes away somehow. One step closer. I have died every day waiting for you. Darling, don't be afraid. I have loved you for a thousand years. I love you for a thousand more. Time stands still.
It was only a smile, but my heart, it went wild. I wasn't expecting that. Just a delicate kiss anyone could have missed. I wasn't expecting that. Did I misread the sign? Your hand slipped into mine. I wasn't expecting that. You spent the night in my bed. You woke up and you said, well, I wasn't expecting that. I thought love wasn't meant to last. I thought you were just passing through. If I ever get the nerve to ask, what did I get right to deserve somebody like you? I wasn't expecting that. It was only a word. It was almost misheard. I wasn't expecting that. But it came without fear. A month turned into a year. I wasn't expecting that. I thought love wasn't meant to last. Honey, I thought you were just passing through. If I ever get the nerve to ask, what did I get right to deserve somebody like you? I wasn't expecting that. In the flicker of the sweetest smile. We were married in spring. You know I wouldn't change a thing without that innocent kiss. What a life I missed.
Friends and family of Izzy and Callum, thank you for being here on this important day. We're gathered together to celebrate the very special love between Izzy and Callum by joining them in marriage. As we begin this important occasion, please know that we're all here to support you, encourage you, hope for you, and to remind you that love is not one moment, not even this moment. It's every moment. The big ones like saying I love you for the first time, becoming engaged, getting married, and having your children, as well as the million little ones that happen every day. These all combine into one big experience that will become your life together. Building a marriage and a life together takes work, but it'll be the most rewarding work that you ever do. It'll take plenty of love. Love should be the foundation of your marriage, and it's the reason that you're here today. It will take trust, to know in your hearts that you want the best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another to learn and to grow together, even when that's not always easy to do. It will take hope to be always willing to go forward to tomorrow, no matter what it may bring. And it will take commitment to hold true to the journey you both now pledge to share together. Marriage allows you a new environment in which to share your lives. To be successful, you will need strength, courage, patience, and a really good sense of humour. You're all very welcome. We especially welcome those that have travelled over from England. Izzy and Callum appreciate all of you being here today to celebrate this very special occasion with them. We would also like to acknowledge the people who've passed on, that both Izzy and Callum wish could be here to share this day. And we particularly remember Izzy's Nana Colette, Callum's granddad James, and Callum's Uncle Derek, better known as Del Boy. We've lit a candle in their honour, and we know that they're smiling down upon you. Now I'd like you all to sit back and relax, because I'm going to tell you a story. The wonderful story of how Izzy and Callum found themselves here today. The clean version. It all started in that most romantic of settings, secondary school. They knew each other as they'd friends in common, but the first time they ever spoke to each other when was Izzy was sitting her junior cert and Callum came down to the school to meet up with some friends. Their first date was to the cinema. They needed a lift to get there, so Callum's sister Eilish drove them. After the movie, they realised that both their phones were dead and they couldn't call anyone for a lift home. So they sat and talked to each other about anything and everything. From the outset, they were so at ease in each other's company as if they'd known each other for years. Finally, Callum's phone turned on and he called his mother for a lift. And as they drove home that evening, they both knew that this was the start of a new journey. The start of something very special. More dates followed, and for Callum, Izzy's house party stands out as the moment he knew he wanted to spend the rest of his life with her. He told all his friends that she was the girl for him, and he was so glad that he was the boy for her. Izzy said she knew Callum was a keeper because she could tell him anything. Anything about her past, and he didn't treat her any differently. In fact, he just loved her more. Their journey so far has included getting their first home and the birth of their two beautiful children, Frankie and Isabel. They absolutely love the little family unit they've created. And they're at their happiest when the four of them are together. This summer, they had a wonderful holiday in Disneyland, making special magic memories in that most magical of kingdoms. They've been through lots of good times and some hard times. Izzy particularly remembers the support Callum gave her when her nanny passed away and how much it meant to her to have him by her side. Being married to them means having goals to work towards together, having someone who will always have your back, and the best part, getting to wake up beside your best friend every day. And so to the proposal. Callum surprised Izzy with a very romantic night away to this lovely hotel to celebrate their anniversary. He'd arranged for a sea view room and for flowers to be in it when Izzy arrived. They were both in great form, so happy being in each other's company and having some time to themselves. They went for a leisurely lunch and then walked to the beach, where they sat and watched the waves crashing off the rocks, looking out to sea, feeling very happy and very much in love. As they walked back to the hotel, they came across the decking pond. Here, Callum stopped, got down on one knee, and asked Izzy, his best friend, to be his wife. And apparently the yes could be heard in Finglas and Wexford. I asked Callum to share with me what he loves about Izzy. He said, I love her personality. She's such a kind, funny person. I just feel so at ease in her company. I love that no matter how annoyed she is, she just cannot stay serious when I look at her. I love that when I decide to do something crazy, she always stands by me and supports me. We're inseparable. I feel so lucky. Over 7 billion people in the world, and here I am marrying my soulmate. The one person in the world that I'm most at home with. The one person that I trust above all else. The one person I can talk to about anything. Izzy is my best friend, and marrying her today means the world to me. Izzy spoke of how Callum can always make her laugh, even when she's angry. She spoke about his love for Frankie and Isabel, and what an amazing dad he is, and how that makes her love him even more. She loves how he's so caring and kind, and always makes her feel safe and protected. She also loves his big smile, and said it just makes her happy to see him happy. They are the best of friends. And as the saying goes, best friends make the good times better and the hard times easier. Marrying Callum means that for as long as they live, she'll have this amazing man as her constant companion. Somebody who loves her, appreciates her, and wants only the best for her and their family. Someone she knows she can rely on. And most importantly, someone who can always make her laugh. She can't wait to be his wife. They're both so thankful to have found each other. People talk about marriage as a commitment. And the definition of a commitment is willingness to give your time and energy to something you believe in. And Callum and Izzy truly believe in each other. They have found each other their place in life. A place that welcomes them, treasures them, and allows them the space to grow. Their love story is what brings us all here today. A love that has grown each year they've been together and will continue to grow throughout their lives. They love the idea of committing to each other and being husband and wife. Izzy and Callum have created a loving, happy home together, along with their beautiful son Frankie and their beautiful daughter Isabel. Over the last few years, they've really grown, both individually and as a couple. They're so supportive of each other's dreams and really motivate each other to be the best versions of themselves they can be. They truly love each other, and they can't believe their luck in finding the one person that to them means home. They laugh a lot, and they enjoy the life that they've created together. And today is a celebration of that life. It's also a testament to anyone having a hard time to have hope. There are wonderful people in this world, and often we will find them. Izzy and Callum are so happy and so in love, it just makes sense that they grow old together. And a final word on their love story? Friends, family, vino and vows. What better way to spend a day? I'd like to share with you now a reading that Izzy and Callum have chosen. Love. I love you not only for what you are, but for what I am when I am with you. I love you not only for what you have made of yourself, but for what you are making of me. I love you for the part of me that only you bring out. I love you for putting your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over all the foolish, weak things that you can't help dimly see there, and for drawing out into the light all the beautiful belongings that no one else had looked quite far enough to find. I love you because you are you, and I am me, and together, we are love. We'll now perform a sand ceremony, and I invite Izzy and Callum to join me to combine their sands. Izzy and Callum, today you're making a lasting commitment to share the rest of your lives together. I ask you both now to take your individual jars of sand and pour them into the vase. The individual jars represent your family of origin and your unique individuality. As your sands are combined, so too your lives are joined. Your combined sands also provide the foundation of your family unit. Today you're also making a bond with your children, Frankie and Isabel, and I'd like to invite them to come forward with Catherine and Ryan and add their sand to the vase to represent their unique personalities and the contribution they make in creating your lovely family. These sands are now combined and can no longer be separated. May your bond of marriage and family always be as inseparable as these sands. May the blessings of life, the joy of love, and the peace of truth be your constant companions now and always. We'll now perform a Celtic hand fasting. This is one of the oldest wedding rituals, and it's where we get the sayings tying the knot and hand in marriage from. The knot represents that which, like love, grows stronger under pressure. We will now add to the binding ribbons that reflect the qualities that Izzy and Callum wish to bring to their marriage. And I invite Izzy's mother, Ellen, to come forward with orange for encouragement and kindness, and gold for energy and wealth. And now invite Callum's mother, Deborah, to come forward with yellow for confidence and joy, black for wisdom and success, and pink for romance and happiness. Izzy and Callum, as your hands are bound together, so too your lives are joined in a union of love and trust. The bonds of marriage are not formed by these cords, for always you'll hold in your own hands the fate of this union. May these hands be healer, protector, shelter and guide for each other. And so the binding of your love and your lives is made. Now time to share your vows. These vows are the promises that you make to each other to ensure that your marriage is even more fantastic than this beautiful wedding. Izzy, do you take Callum here today, honouring all that has come before, all that is now, and all that will ever be?
I do.
Callum, do you take Izzy, honouring all that has come before, all that is now, and all that will ever be?
I do.
We'll now have the ring exchange, and can I ask Ryan, the best man, to please come forward with the rings? Thank you. Yeah. He's
is it just the opposite?
Yeah. You could sit. Thank you very much, Ryan. Okay. So I'll just say what they mean first, and then. So rings are a precious metal. They are also made precious by your wearing of them. Your wedding rings are special. They enhance your commitment to one another. They mark the beginning of your long journey together. Your wedding ring is a circle, a symbol of love never ending. It's the seal of the vows that you have taken to love each other without end. Izzy, please place the ring on Callum's ring finger and repeat after me. This ring is a token of my love.
This ring is a token of my love.
I marry you with this ring.
I marry you with this ring.
With all that I have.
And all that I am.
Callum, can you please place the ring on Izzy's ring finger and repeat after me?
This ring is a token of my love.
This ring is a token of my love.
I marry you with this ring.
I marry you with this ring.
With all that I have.
With all that I have.
And all that I am.
And all that I am.
Now I'm going to just stand out from
Izzy and Callum, we have witnessed you pledge your love to each other here today in front of family and friends. You've strengthened the bond between you with the vows spoken and the giving and the receiving of rings. Therefore, it gives me great pleasure to say the words you've been waiting to hear. I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Please be upstanding for the bride and groom.
This is love in Italy.
I am a sailor, you're my first mate. We signed on together, we coupled our fate. Hold up our anchor, determined not to fail. For the heart's treasure, together we set sail. With no maps to guide us, we steered our own course. Rode out the storms when the wind were gale force. Sat out the doldrums in patience and hope. Working together, we learned how to cope. Life is an ocean and love is a boat. In troubled waters, started the voyage, there was just me and you. Now gathered round us, we have our own crew. Together we're in this relationship. We built it with care to last the whole trip. Our true destination's not marked on any chart. We're navigating for the shores of the heart. Life is an ocean and love is a boat.
troubled waters that keeps us afloat. When we started the voyage, there was just me and you. Now gathered round us, we have our own crew. Life is an ocean, and love is a boat. In troubled waters, it keeps us afloat. When we started the voyage, there was just me and you. Now gathered round us, we have our own crew.
Love for me, darling, just dive right in, follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. Just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time, but darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, your song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it, darling, you look perfect tonight. Well, I found a woman stronger than anyone I know. Shares my dreams, I hope that someday I'll share her home. I found a love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own. We'll be right back.
in me, always with me. Tiny dancer in my hand. Jesus, please, out on the street, and then take a sound for God.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Izzy's going to kick us off with the speeches. Right, I'd like to thank you all for coming. I'm just going to wing it, by the way, just saying. I did write it last night, but a few drinks kind of got a bit out of hand. I'd love to thank people, especially that came from Dublin. And the people that came all the way over from England. I think that's a longer journey. England. And the Wexford people as well, I suppose. Woohoo!
What was it?
And Boule of Oak. Yeah. I'm just going to say, I hope you all enjoy your night. User. I'm glad to be a part of the Gahan family now. Hey. Welcome you with open arms.
When do you want
your fingers? Shut up, yeah. No, I went blank now.
You may get done, Callum. Gifts.
Well, we have a few gifts to give out. So, Callum, John. I'm trying to figure out where everyone is now, so I can hand them out. I'm lost. No, I'm kind of making eyeballs. I don't want them to know who. Right. Yeah. First one's for my wonderful mother-in-law. Because if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have any flowers. Second one's for my wonderful mammy. If it wasn't for her, I wouldn't be here. Third one's for Liz Fitzgerald.
Where's Liz?
Over there. Because all the wonderful invitations she's got was made by her by hand. Callum, she's over there. Ivana. No, Ivana. Shove it there. The next one's for Ivana. Coming all the way down from Dublin to do this for us.
Yeah, no, just you. And last but least, the next one's for Emer. Because if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have any of this done. So I'm just going to say now, enjoy the night and drink on. Because that's it. I'm done.
David, yeah?
Now we have David with a few words.
What the fuck? Hold on. I can't look with the people behind me back. First of all, I'd like to thank you all for coming to our daughter's wedding. It's hard to believe the youngest child has grown up into this beautiful woman you see before you. Doesn't seem so long ago she was sitting at the table demanding a bottle of tea and a candy cigarettes. You remember them? You were a little L one then. Then came the diva stage. Oh my God. Nicking lipsticks out of people's bags, putting it on, coming out from behind the curtain, singing Lady Marmalade. Remember that, huh? She's such a mad little child. She's a diva, smart, beautiful, crazy. Then we had an incident in her life where Izzy was involved in an accident a long time ago. And it's hard to believe that we nearly lost her. But a pure strength and stubbornness got her through it. All I can say is that when Izzy wants something, Izzy has it in her mind, she'll go and get it. And she will not stop. There's many times in the hospital, Izzy will sneak out of a hospital bed, in casts, barely able to move, and she'd end up down in the nurse's canteen eating curry. We got a phone call from the hospital one day saying that Izzy went missing, and they didn't know where she was. And after a big search all throughout the hospital, she was found in the kitchen, no doubt. Hiding in the fridge, robbing all the food. That's true. While she was in ICU, she was hooked up to many machines. As she recovered, a song came on the radio. It was the Black Eyed Peas, Where's the Love? And as she came around, she asked us, listen to the song, listen to the words, where's the love? We're going to say the same thing we did back then, say it to you now. Look all around you, it's all here today. Shut up. I'm not finished yet. Then came the teenage years. Oh, wait, let me tell you about the teenage years. When this little shit came on the scene. Izzy saw something with him. I just saw a little poochie. Now, you got to remember, a little poochie was a little courier from Finglas who made me run miles after him because he robbed my bike. But if Izzy has her mind set on something, she won't stop until she gets it. She's stubborn. That's where she got the name BB from. Bossy bitch. Now they're married, two beautiful kids, Frankie and Isabel, wherever she is out there. He must have known he found the real gem, because if he'd had to work for it, he'd have never turned up. Actually surprised he's here today. As long as he takes good care of her and keeps her smiling, that's fine by us. Because remember, Callum, I sleepwalk and you only live down the road. All that said, thanks all again for coming. Hope you all have a great day. I'd like you all to join me. Please grab a hold of your glass. Raise a toast. Bride and groom. Thank you.
So how do you follow that?
Drink up.
Yeah, have a drink. So no. I'd like to thank you all for coming here, sharing the special day with Izzy and Callum. You're such a mess.
Mom.
For as long as we could remember, we never thought you would have a special day like this, let alone have two beautiful kids. And for years and years, you kept getting told you're not going to have this day. But you like proving people wrong. So when someone told you can't walk, she's like, I'll show you. And you haven't stopped since. And then the next thing came along. The next thing came along, well, she's not going to have children. Well, I'll show you too. And then when people kept telling you can't achieve and you can't achieve true happiness, you showed them. And for that, Callum, I'd like to thank you. Although you annoy me sometimes, I do appreciate everything you do for Izzy. Oh no. So I got you a little present.
Right.
Oh,
I'm a little bit emotional.
Don't wreck the place, like. What I have here for you, Callum, is the guardian angel. Alright. I have it to watch over you as you watch over Izzy and my beautiful nephew and niece. So you hold on to this for everything you do. Alright. I know, yeah. And for Izzy, anyone that knows Izzy, she is obsessed with elephants. Hence why Callum is here.
You had to do
it. And like Izzy, elephants are magnificent creatures. They're kind, they're strong, they're very wise, and they never forget anything. She still asks me for the clothes I rub on her. So what I have here for you, Izzy.
Some clothes?
No. You're not getting them back. I have a bracelet here for you. With a nice big elephant. To show you that. For your strength and courage. And a blessing. I love you. Well, I was going to say half something my dad said, but look, he got there first. So I'm kind of winging it. Thank you all again for coming to the bride and groom.
Just say thanks for coming.
Oh, shit. I'd like to thank everybody for coming today. And congratulating to Izzy and Callum. And welcome to the family, Izzy. God, you're coming in for some punishment. Yeah, you might want to run now. But anyway, thank you and welcome to the family. And thank you for the flowers.
Hey, well done, yeah?
Ah! like you all to do is to give them a huge, warm welcome out onto the dance floor for their first dance. Your bride and groom, make some noise for them. Elizabeth and Callum, make some noise.
Wise man said, only fools rush in. But I can't help falling in love with you.
Welcome the rest of us, I'm happy to the floor.
Standing on the wall, get your back up off the wall. Blame it on the money. Don't blame it on the social. Don't blame it on the money.